I start the project by planing all sides at a stock square. Remember to keep track of those measurements. I then mark the ends ready to be trimmed to size. Then using the width of the wood itself, I mark out my rabbet joint. I continue this process throughout the project. Also using a square, I measure the depth of my cut. I then score a nice deep line with my marking knife prior to cutting a knife wall. A knife wall will ensure a nice clean straight cut. I then use a router plane to cut my rabbet. This can be a very long and slow process, but it is very precise and very clean. When cutting a rabbet joint on the end piece of wood, try having another piece of wood the same size adjacent to it. This will help balance out the router plane when cutting. Also, remember to cut in from both sides. This will prevent tear out. As well as using a depth gauge on the router plane, you can also tidy up the joint using a paring chisel. Another effective method of cutting a rabbet is making a series of cuts and then removing the stock with a chisel. For best control over the chisel, use it beveled down. This will prevent it from cutting straight down into the wood. loosen up the joint, use a chisel bevel up. This can either be a paring chisel or a normal bench chisel. Then glue all the pieces together, making sure it's square. Then mark out where I'm going to drill my holes for my dowels. I put two dowels in the end of each cross section. This will prevent it from ever slipping. Once dry, I then flush saw the dowels. I use a block plane to round off the harsh edges. Thank you. I see the pesky cat. And where I can't reach with the block plane, I just use a chisel to start it off, and then I'll finish it off with sandpaper later. I then use a 220 grit sandpaper just to smooth it off. Once I've positioned my hinges, I mark it more permanently with a marking knife. I then use a chisel to set my depth of cut. Apply two coats of Danish oil and then two coats of varnish just for the extra protection.